Now we have studied the filter structures as in whatever I have written the equation. If these two equations are satisfied, no matter how kind of which kind of whichever kind of system it is, the input and the output will be reconstructed as per the inputs. Now if in some sense if H0, like according to this equation, what is derived is that this H0 by H1 of minus Z and minus Z is to be equal to minus of G1 by G0. Now if I take this these filters equivalently, or in some sense what I am trying to say is that I take H0 is equal to minus of this G1 is equal to minus of H0 of minus Z, and G0 is this filter, or in some sense if these two filters are same, let me explain how in HARP it was. In HARP, if H0 was, in some sense, if I take this as 1,1 or 1 plus Z inverse, then H0 of Z, then what G1 has to be? Minus of H0 of minus Z, which is 1 minus Z inverse. So in that sense G1 is minus of 1 minus Z inverse, and this G0 was equal to H1 of minus Z, which comes out to be H1 was equal to 1 minus Z inverse, 1 minus minus Z inverse, which comes out to be plus Z inverse. So G0 was equal to H0, or in same sense if we use the same kinds of filters, or in some sense even the wavelet, in some sense such kind of filter banks are called orthogonal filter banks. And when these two filters are different, or in some sense use different kind of structures for the synthesis side and for the analysis side and the synthesis side, then we call such type of filter banks as bi-orthogonal filter banks. So JPEG uses some sort of bi-orthogonal filter bank structure. Now in that sense, if you see, just for now let us just forget everything and remember how this psi of t was reconstructed using psi of 2t. Now psi of t is something which goes from 0 to 1, and this is 1, and the psi of 2t stuff goes from this here to here, which is 0.5. So in some sense I can say that psi of t is equal to psi of 2t plus psi of 2t minus 1. Okay, can I say it like this? Yes. Okay, now if I add these two I am able to reconstruct. Now if I see, take psi t convolved with psi t, which is this triangle from 0 to 2 having this one. Even this can be represented in terms of twice as, yes it can be, because this will be nothing but, what is convolution? Convolution is nothing but polynomial multiplication. So in that sense, if you see, if I take this function, this was nothing but डेल्टा ऑफ टी सी सी सी. सो इन दैट सेंस दिस विल बी वन कॉमा माइनस वन टाइप ऑफ इन द दैट स्पेस कन्वॉल्व विथ सॉरी वन कॉमा प्लस प्लस वन कॉमा प्लस वन प्लस वन कॉमा प्लस वन. इफ आई कन्वॉल्व बोथ ऑफ देन देन दे विल गेट द प्रोडक्ट विल बी वन टू वन. जस्ट चेक इट. लेट मी एक्सप्लेन व्हाट विल हैपन. फाइ ऑफ टू टी प्लस फाइ ऑफ टू टी माइनस वन when I convolve it with itself then what comes out. See phi of 2t convolved with phi of 2t will give me in some sense this structure which let me let me represent it some form. Okay, so it will be in that sense this triac of 2t and divided by 1 by 2 because this scaling factor 1 upon alpha like because there is property h alpha t involved with x alpha t gives 1 upon alpha times y alpha t. That is this property. So according to that property I am writing. So half times triangular one. Now similarly this convolved with this will give me this and this convolved will give me again half will be common in all of them. This will give me triangular, this will give me again this triangular but with shift 2t minus 1. Okay, because 2t and 2t minus 1 will overall shift because this is delta of t minus half and this is delta of t, so overall there will be delta of t minus half. This will be 2 times because this and this will be 2 times because this part and this part they both will be happening. So this will be 2 times trig of 2t minus 1 plus triangular of 2t minus 2. So in that sense this filter in the 2t space will be nothing but half times the coefficient of trig of 2t is 1, trig of 2t minus 1 is 2 and 2t minus 2 is 1. So in that sense half, 1 and 1 and half. So what does this mean geometrically? Geometrically it means that 0 to 1 this is 1 and this is 2. This is the original kind of a function. I can reconstruct this function by adding this these three kind of see this is triangular of 2t, this is triangular of 2t minus 2, 2t minus 2 and this part is 2 times triangular this is and the scaled is half. So this is half times triangular of 2t, this is half times triangular of 2t minus 2 and this is 1 times triangular of 2t minus 1. So in that sense if I add these three up then I am able to reconstruct this spline again. So spline, what is spline? I use the spline first time. Now this spline is nothing but a sort of an interpolator. Now what does interpolation means? Interpolation means that for example these points you are given and you are told to join, then if I join them linearly then we call such interpolator as linear interpolator. If I use the sampling theorem to find out the frequency in do something, then what I will do is that I will add up syncs, and by the frequency I will get a smooth low pass version which is called sync interpolation. Okay, let me explain it in this way. Okay, this is the time, this is function. I am given some discrete points. This is these are points p1, p2, p3, p4, p5. Now if I am told to join it, to join or interpolate the spaces or fill the spaces in between in some sense, if I use such kind of stuff, then it is called linear interpolation. If I use sync some form of stuff, then this becomes sync interpolation. This is sync interpolation. This was linear interpolation. So there are different forms of ways in which we can approximately, this is nothing but approx finding the values in between. So what is the value of the function between x1 and x2, some point x, so we can find it approximately. So this kind of approximation is called interpolation, and spline, this kind of a spline is sort of an interpolator. So now in JPEG compression, what we use is a sort of an interpolation technique, and in this case, this way, the low pass filter at the analysis side, and the low pass filter at the analysis side, and the low pass filter at the synthesis side are different. Rather, what we can say is that at the synthesis side, the low pass filter is smooth, more smooth. So now, what kind of a low pass filters and the structure of this JPEG 2005x3 structure is, and how the structure derives, that also we will be understanding. But for now, let's just see. So here, we use this triangular kind of interpolator, this kind of a spline. It has a great amount of use because this is almost equal to some Gaussian curve, but Gaussian is not realizable so well. So we use this kind of a triangle, which is very good one. So in that sense, this is 1 plus Z inverse whole square. Okay, so this comes out, this is the same, 1 plus 2z inverse plus z inverse, this is a minus 2, this kind of filter we use here. So this is h0, and similarly I use this g0, this as equal to 1 minus let me not write it because it has to be remained on here. Okay, now by the alias cancellation equation, what do we get? This g0 of z upon g1 of z has to be equal to minus of h1 of z divided by h0, sorry, of minus z h1. Now if this is equal, we can have some constant multiplied on the both the sides. Now this constant we take, this constant we take two different filter banks. So in that sense, at the receiver end, this g1 set, we take some different kind of filter. This filter is similar to 1 plus z inverse whole square times this filter, just see. So this is, let me write it only, 1 minus z inverse whole square. H1. So this is h1 of minus z, which is the same as h0. So h1 of minus z is equal to h0, first of all. Just see. So h1 of minus z times, so now for this perfect reconstruction condition, what we need is that this must be this sort of an equation which I am writing kappa of z, which is nothing but equal to 1 plus z inverse whole square times 1 plus, this was h0, times g0, which is 1 plus z inverse whole square times, let me just change it to 1 plus pz inverse instead of minus, which I will do, plus z raised power minus 2. I am taking it because I want to get some low pass structure, this linear phase system, sort of a structure. So this must be like equal to, this must have this odd samples equal to 0 except the dth samples, because the even samples will automatically get cancelled in the overall this upsampling and downsampling stuff. So we don't need to worry about the even samples except the, what we can say is the dth sample. Except the dth sample, every else odd numbers, the odd sequence, because d will be something like dv5, then the seventh sample, this third samples have to be deliberately made zero, because sixth, eighth, the adjacent of the this sixth, this eighth, this tenth, they will automatically be zero by up down sampling. So down up sampling, sorry. So the down up sampling process, the first down sampling and then up sampling will make this 6 and 8 0. So we just need to make this 7th as 0, this 3rd as 0, this 1st as 0. So in that sense, we have to make odd sample 0 except the dth sample. This is the whole square, so raised to the power 4 I am expanding, okay? Just looking at it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 4, 1, 3, 4, 3, 6, 3, 4, 3, 1, this is again 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. So now if I write this, 1, 4 plus p, 4p plus 6, plus 1, just let me write here, 1, 4 plus p, 4p, plus 6 plus 1, which is 4p plus 7, then this comes out to be, so this is equal to 6p plus 8, and then this again comes 4p plus 7, then this comes again 3 plus 4, and then it comes again 1. So if you just see, this is 0th position, this is 1st, this is 2nd, this is 3rd, this is 4th, this is 5th, this is 6th. So just see the locations, how. So in this structure, just see this part, it can be anything in this structure. The third point can be anything. The first and the fifth have to be deliberately made equal to zero, because this is how much delay will be introduced by the stuff. Okay, so this d is equal to t. Why? Because the highest power, just see what is the highest power. So this 4 plus p has to be equal to 0, or p has to be equal to minus 4. This is what is the shortcoming of the overall analysis. Why? Because if I place this 3 is equal to 0, then it will become linear phase. Just to get the linear phase, I am just shifting it by the side. So the d is equal to 3 here, this delay. Okay, so if I take this d equal to 3, then if I get p is equal to minus 4, then everything is set up. So if I take this p is equal to minus 4, then my coefficients will become equal to 1, 0. This can be anything. Minus 16 plus 7, which is equal to minus 9. This becomes equal to, or let me just write 1 plus z inverse whole square times 1 minus 4, 1, which finally comes out to be equal to 1 minus 2 minus 6 minus 2, 1. And this kind of a filter is what we use it at this G0. So just let me summarize everything. So in summary, we use a filter 1 plus z inverse on the whole square on the analysis side. And we use a filter 1 plus z inverse whole square times 1 minus 4 z inverse plus z raised to minus 2 on the synthesis side. And similarly, this will be equal to 1 minus z inverse times whole square times 1 minus 4 z inverse plus z raised to minus 2. This is same here. And this is input and this is output. By this, what we do, this is input, this is output. In some sense, we get this JPEG 2000 compression standards, and these are defined worldwide. The important thing is that we use this spline or this bi-orthogonal reconstruction stuff. Okay, where this synthesis side is more smoother in the low pass and the more, and then as compared to the this analysis side, and we get a linear phase system because of the symmetrical property. So that's all which is important for you to know.